When I've had conversations about custom PCBs made with KiCad, creating a custom outline with specific dimensions for the board is something that people often ask about. I'm sure there are users who are used to the drawing tools in KiCad and are able to quickly sketch out board outline exactly the way they want, but many of us find it frustrating and too limited. For that reason, I will almost always use other tools to sketch the outline of the PCB and then import the drawing to KiCad's EdgeCut layer. The software I use is the sketching part of Fusion 360. I'll show the process with two examples after introducing the sponsor of this video, PCBWAY.com. PCBWAY.com offers basic PCB starting from just $5 for 10 pieces of 10x10cm PCBs. Here are samples of some, but not all, of the different color options available. If your project requires more advanced PCBs, 3D printed parts, or CNC milled parts, don't worry, you can order them from PCBWAY.com as well. For all your prototyping and low volume production needs, go check out PCBWAY.com for up-to-date information on their offering. Also, check out shared projects and module store sections of their website. Some PCBs don't need to be exact size or shape. In some cases, it is sufficient to draw a rectangle around the components in KiCad and call it a day. But for most PCBs, there's need for specific dimensions, more complicated shapes, or exact placement of mounting holes, for example. In that case, I love Fusion 360's parametric sketching tools, which allow adding dimensions and constraints to specify the exact shape and relationship between different shapes. Before going any further, I must say Fusion 360 is overkill if drawing PCB outlines is all you want to do. I have it installed for doing 3D CAD and CAM stuff to be used with 3D printer and CNC router, so I'm used to using it and I will use it for this as well. As an example, I will draw outline for this kind of board. This is 50x70mm board with, I believe, 3.2mm mounting holes and rounded corners. First thing to do is listing the parameters or the known numeric values that are to be used in this design. When using parameters or variables, it is easy to use same values in multiple places, and if the design changes, changing the value in this list will change it in all the places the parameter was used in, just like when defining constant values in programming. I have defined following parameters: width 50mm, length 70mm, hole diameter 3.2mm, and corner radius 5mm. Those are all the dimensions that are needed to definitely describe this board shape without room for different interpretations. Simplest way of drawing this board shape is using create rectangle, for example the 2-point rectangle. Place one corner by clicking somewhere on the sketch. Then instead of clicking second time on another spot, write the dimensions in two text fields that follow the rectangle's sides. I defined parameters called width and length, so I will write those names instead of the numerical values. Tab on the keyboard will switch between the two fields. Hit enter to place the rectangle with given dimensions. In the beginning, I defined that corners should be rounded with radius of 5mm. It can be done with fillet tool found in modify menu. In sketching part of Fusion, fillet can be applied by either selecting the corner point or the two sides. Either way, radius can be typed, and again, I don't give the numerical value, but the previously defined parameter's name. Last thing is adding the mounting holes to corners. The mounting hole's center point should be at the center point of the corner arc. This can be easily done by using center diameter circle tool. With that tool, I need to first place the center of the circle, and when I hover the cursor over the center point of the corner arc, it will snap to that point. Clicking that point and giving the diameter, in this case predefined corner radius parameter, the circle will be placed at the position I wanted. I can also at first skip the definition of the diameter and also place the circle anywhere on the sketch. Setting its diameter afterwards can be done by pressing D on keyboard for dimension tool and clicking the circle. Placing the circle in the center of the corner arc can be done using concentric in the constraint menu. Activating it and clicking circle and arc will move the circle to correct position. Now I have the basic shape done and it's time to get it from Fusion to KiCad. Exporting the sketch as DXF file supported by KiCad can be done by right-clicking the sketch on the browser tree and selecting Save as DXF. Then go to KiCad's PCB layer editor. You may have components already in there or blank sheet like I have. Then select File, Import, Graphics. Select the file you just saved in Fusion 360 or any other software and make sure the selected graphic layer is EdgeCut and import scale is 1. Because I had some extra lines in the sketch and they are imported with actual outline, I will unselect the group items, hit OK and import the drawing. Now, after placing the imported sketch, I will select the lines and other features that aren't part of the actual outline and delete them with delete key. By saving separate files for most common PCB shapes that you are going to use, you can save time in future by using those DXF files as templates, instead of drawing the outlines every time from scratch. For more complicated shapes, you can draw something close to that what you want and then apply constraints. For example, if I want to make a notch on the shorter edge of the PCB, 20 mm from the corner, 60 mm wide, 8 mm deep, I can sketch it with line tool. And it doesn't need to have 90 degree angles or placed in correct spot at first. I can use the perpendicular constraint to make the corners 90 degrees. Or I can use parallel constraint to make the individual lines of the notch to have the same orientation as sides of the PCB's outline. Then using key D for dimension, I can set the correct distance as well as the dimensions. Distance of two items is set by selecting both items when dimension tool is active. Defining length, radius or other main dimension of one item is done by selecting only one item. Now there is rectangle where I want the notch to be, and trim tool can be used to remove that section of original outline that is no more used. One more example of the power of constraints could be that original PCB shape, but drawn using lines and arcs instead of rectangle. I can draw some kind of four-sided shape with arcs in the corners without concentrating on making things line up perfectly. Then I'll add tangent constraint to make transition from straight line into arc smooth. Then add horizontal slash vertical constraints to turn those tilted lines into horizontal and vertical lines. It still looks a bit off because the radius of each rounded corner is different. Adding predefined parameter corner radius to each of those will fix that. Then it's just adding the mounting holes and exporting the file the same way as in the first example. With this video, I want to show that you don't have to struggle with KiCad's limited sketching tools when trying to create your custom PCB designs. I also want to emphasize the power of constraints and dimensions in CAD softwares. There are countless different scenarios that can be solved by applying constraints. Mastering the use of constraints and defined parameters is the key to accurate sketch, and accurate sketch is the key to perfect designs, no matter if you are using them to create 3D models or PCB outlines. I hope I achieved my goal of making approachable getting started video for creating PCB outlines for KiCad projects using Fusion 360. I wanted to make a step-by-step video while keeping it simple and relatively short. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.